What's up, guys? CraZi HD here, back with another episode of Recore. So I just read up on all the lore, all the journal entries, all the logs and stuff. So found out that everyone gets one of these crawlers, which is huge. Protects them in cryo sleep and stuff like that. He is MA3K, but they call him Mac, and a couple other things. This is the workbench. Here, Jewel can research and equip new parts, change loadouts, and upgrade her core bots. Research the blueprint and replace Mac's broken parts with new ones. Alright. So we're gonna research, yeah.
Perfect.
Now equip the part to Mac's frame. Alright. You have additional blueprints in your inventory. Gather the required materials and return to the workbench to research and equip these new parts. Keep your eyes open for more blueprints as you explore far even.
Ready to help me fix that terraforming pylon?
Oop, we got a new log. Four new logs. Mandate is always striving for a better tomorrow. The greatest expression of this philosophy is the core AI, where each core's birth is only the beginning of a journey toward greatness. Cores have the ability to learn and become stronger after they have been forged. As cores work and gain experience, they level up, earning small boosts to their primary attributes or stats. Each level gained greatly increases a core's stat potential. But the only way to actually raise these stat numbers to their maximum is to use something known as core fusion. Core fusion is the process of combining two or more cores, or of combining cores with core shards. Indeed, core fusion is one of the best ways to repurpose rogue cores. Cores and core shards can be fused with your companion cores at the workbench inside your crawler. Alright. Core incubation is an exacting process with variability carefully calibrated to create cores with characteristics perfectly suited to their roles in constructing Far Eden. In short, every newly forged core is unique. Different between cores are expressed by the following base characteristics or stats. Attack dictates how much damage a core will dish out. Defense determines how much damage a core could absorb. Energy determines how many lethal attacks a core can perform. These stats influence certain core attributes. Health is determined by attack and defense stats. Shield shows the level of this extra layer of protection above core health. Lethal is a special attack baked into every core and is not linked with any stats. RNG, or random number generator, determines the percent chance that a lethal attack will inflict a secondary effect, stun, destabilize, fire. Knockout time is dictated by the energy stat and defines how long a core takes to recover from a knockout. Attack rate defines how quickly a core performs an attack and is also dictated by the energy stat. Remember, a core bot's maximum stat potential can always be raised with core fusion. See the core fusion entry for more details. And I don't feel like reading blueprints or anything. Each time the crawler is entered, the cores, shards, and loot in your inventory is automatically transferred to the crawler stash. You can check your stash at any time by using the workbench. Okay. From what I've heard, this is a big issue, is the load times, but so far what I've seen, not anywhere near as bad as Homefront the Revolution. The only reason I keep comparing it to that is because that was one of the glitchiest games of the year, and also because it's the last game I played.
In the next sector, Mac. Let's get going.
I like that extraction thing.
There's the crawler gate. I'll have to initiate the manual override since our hunk of junk is buried in the sand.
She made it sound like it was going to be a pain in the ass. I'm pretty sure this is an indie developer. Not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure Armature, I think is how you say it, is an indie developer. And Concept.
Eden was the closest planet with an Earth-like atmosphere. It wasn't perfect, but it sure had potential.
Why are they even trying?
Stay alert, Mac. The core bots in this sector look corrupted too. The pylon. It's totally grounded. Pylon before that storm hits. That structure is the pylon's control center. Or what's left of it, anyway.
Oh, leave me alone. I hope you guys know I'm not actually pissed off when I do that. I'm not complaining that there's enemies because it makes it more interesting. Guess I'm not getting up there. I'll try that. Hey, I got up here. And that enemy can wait. He can try killing me later. I got shit to
Are
grab.
Those canine oh, God. Things? They don't look like any I've ever seen.
Uh-oh. Mac, I think we're about to die. Just kidding. I'm safe. Uh-huh. You know that. I'll get them in a second. I just want to get all this stuff.
Someone must have modified the frames. But why?
Crawler around a rockfall that wasn't on any of the surveys. But most of the core bots are in fine condition, and the prime core is safe, thank God. We'd never be able to terraform this planet without it. In 200 years, Far Eden will have blue skies, water, trees. It will be a paradise, like Earth before Dust Devil. Victor will be overseeing construction of the first stage facilities while I get the prime core online. If he and the other core bots continue to perform as well as I designed them, I might not need to wake any of the other humans for this shift.
Alright. Found my first glitch. You guys don't know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about how that waypoint won't go away. I think this would make a good multiplayer game.
We need to get inside, quick!
Once the pylons were up and running, we figured it would take about 200 years to stabilize the environment. Of course, if any of the pylons failed, all bets were off.
Only like, what the hell's it down?
Go.
That is a good tip to know. Fire in short bursts. Didn't even think of that. I really thought they kind of over-exaggerated. I watched the Game Ranks video on the Before You Buy. I really thought they kind of over-exaggerated.
Feels good to get out of that storm, huh, boy?
With how bad the load times are.
Alright, let's find the pylon controls.
Like, they made it sound like it was gonna take hours to load everything.
Hey, another transfer plate. Just like the one in our crawler. Let's check it out. Huh. Looks like there's something stuck in the memory buffer.
What the hell?
Yes, of course I'm a human. My name is Jewel. What's your name? Violet? V10LT? Oh, you're the one locking down the transfer plates. But why? The revolution? I think Violet might be missing a few bolts, if you know what I mean.
The first probes we sent to Far Eden found pockets of rare minerals on the surface. We all suspected we'd find a lot more underground.
Up there! The pylon controls. Come on, Mac.
Alright, so we gotta get over here. Activate the pylon.
Huh. I guess one of these cores isn't enough. We'll need more to reboot the pylon.
Find more mysterious mysterious cores to fix the pylon. Okay. I just got a little bit of frame rate lag. No big deal. Not complaining.
Oh look, this door has some sort of color-coded lock on it. What is it, boy? Don't mind if I do.
Rifle red affinity upgrade.
Ooh! A red ammunition amplifier. Maybe it'll help with that door.
Yep, not what I wanted him to do.
Come to me.
Man, I just can't catch a break. Shot while switched to an affinity color will fire an affinity charge shot. These projectiles have a chance to
part of a status shift effect targets based on the color fired. A red affinity charge shot has a chance to light targets on fire.
Pressure plate must be linked to the socket, but it's missing all of its power cells. You got the scent, Mac? Cellbot! I know where you belong, little fella. Follow me. Mac, dig in! See if there's anything here. Mac, dig in. Take a look, buddy.
I'm assuming this is how you get the power, the cell bots.
You got the scent, Mac? Take a look. Mac, dig in.
It's not like clearly explained how you find them.
Give it a look.
Oops.
You got the scent, Mac?
shoot. Okay, so I just gotta look for little green things on the ground, I guess.
Ringer Corbites. They ought to help me get to the other side.
Not that that's not good, but... God damn it, I hit boost instead of jump. So you gotta come down here with me. You guys are probably like cursing me out and calling me stupid right now because I just wasted so much time on that. Alright, there's another cell bot. Now that I understand what I'm looking for, it's not as hard. I thought I had to dig in all these random places and shit. Nope. So I wonder if that means I'm missing two specific ones, or... places, because you see how they went. Alright, I think I see one over there. Check the rest of up here. And there's the last one over there. Okay. Thank you.
That took longer than it needed to. Alright, I'm not trying to be rude, but I have some really important texts I need to get to. Jesus, that took me that long. I was able to respond to 3 texts.
Now I need to extract the core. One down, 2 more to go.
All right. I got all the way back here. I'm gonna keep going until we beat this mission, and then that's when I'll end the episode. I don't like to stop things in the middle of missions, because I... I still haven't gotten any E-turn. It's like currency in this game, if you guys didn't read it. Let's go fix this core.
Do you hear that? There must be another one of those cores nearby. Dead end. The core must be around here somewhere. Matt, can you find it? Go on. You can find it. Good boy. Come on, Mac. That's number 2.
Isn't that number 3, though? Yeah.
Excuse me. I'm getting a little bit of frame rate lag, but it's nowhere near as bad as I thought it would be when I watched some of the reviews. So we gotta figure out a way to get up here. Oh, right here. Okay. That wasn't that hard. Boss fight. All right. Skullcracker. These boss names are kind of corny.
Last core we need is inside that thing's head.
First death of Recore. Alright.
Over here. Come on, Mac.
Wish I could skip this. I know so many people who would make some horny
point.
looks like I don't have it. And I died again.
So I gotta kill the minions first, I think. Like, he releases those little guys, especially then they're blue, so I gotta kill them before I try to target the boss, I think. Because I think that's what's getting me killed. If I don't beat it this time, we're gonna end the episode here. I'm probably gonna rage quit. And yeah. Gonna do this for this episode, guys. Comment, like, subscribe, follow me on Twitter, be on Twitter for blows. I was guys for CraZi HD. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. See you.